Next on the agenda is this little Marshall amp with a sick input. We're told that it cuts out, and then when you plug it in and out again, it comes back. So what I know is with these things, there's a bunch of legs that solder into a circuit board here. And what happens is, because this gets a little stressed, sometimes those solder connections break away from the circuit board. I've seen this before. That's my guess. Unfortunately, we got to rip the whole son of a bitch apart to fix it. So I got to get this thing to do what they say it does, which is stop. I might just go with cleaning the insides of that input jack with a little abrasive first before I even put Mr. Tone generator through it. If you get a look how this works, I can see the switch contacts moving, so I can't see it's not connecting, but when this, if this gets pushed down, you can see how this solders in that way, so it can create stress. Let me see if I can get it to stop working. Yeah, creating stress, cracking. There's probably like four, maybe even six solder connections on the back side of this board, but you see, you have to take every knobulator off this crazy contraption to release the circuit board, to even just see if that's really what's going on. So I gotta get it to stop, and then I'll know. So isn't that pleasant? It cuts out, and then when you do that, it comes back. I can't get it to cut out. So I can't say it's a mechanical failure at this point. Yeah, so both channels work. All I can do at this point now is leave it here on the bench squawking away while I run away from it, because I'm gonna pull my ears off in a minute. I cannot get this to stop. Doing exactly what it's supposed to do. This thing's been groaning under here for 2 hours. I can't get it to stop. It's doing exactly what an amplifier is supposed to do. Amplify. So at this point, all I can do is put it back together, take it upstairs, put a guitar through it, and play the living frickin' shit out of it and try and make it stop. But I cannot find a fault with the input as thus far. The heat sink did get really good and hot though, so you know, it's like it's not component failure. That's the other deal with the blanket. If there's something in there that's going to quit, heat will make it quit faster. That's what they do when they build this crap. They burn it in an unbelievable hot room for usually 72-hour period. It's called accelerated component failure. I used to do it once upon a time for a stupid company. Well, I can't seem to get her to fail, so I'm just gonna wail through it for a bit and whatever the hell happens, I don't know. It's like,
coached it.